where her character can go. I'll have to ask John and Dave, and maybe see where it goes. But right now, I'm just beyond thrilled to just be with Boba in the Book of Boba Fett. You know, it's so much fun, and I love having that sort of ensemble work. You know, it's not always great to be number one. You're there every day. Thank you.
Thanks for the question.
Thank you.
Yes, go ahead over here.
Hi.
Hi.
Hi, thanks for coming to Vancouver. Yeah, I remember watching the first time. I think the first time I saw that you and Bob was Mulan back in 1998. And I also enjoyed your performance in The Mandalorian and Book of Boba Fett. Yeah, I was quite surprised that you were going to be in The Mandalorian. So this is a more fun question. Since you're a big Star Wars geek, do you have a favorite Star Wars meme?
Favorite meme?
From Star Wars.
From Star Wars. There's so many.
What's your favorite Star Wars meme?
What was that?
I am the Senate.
I am the Senate.
I don't know. I hate like trying to answer a question like that. So I'm not going to then.
Maybe we'll give you like a couple examples next time, and you pick your favorite. Like the shirts.
Yeah, exactly. Thank you.
Thank you so much. Go ahead.
Hi.
Oh, jeez. Okay.
Oh,
sorry.
You can just call
you
me.
Got this.
You can just call me Maine.
No, it's more I'm mildly freaking out right now, but I'm glad.
That's so sweet.
I have been a fan of yours since Mulan, and I've loved everything that you've ever been in. Anytime I ever see you are involved in a project, I'm immediately into it, and I love it.
Okay, well this week, I'm gonna plug it. This week, Young Sheldon. I don't know if it's the same time.
Oh, yeah.
But I do an episode of Young Sheldon, so just
right on.
So, I had to write this down because I'm terrible with thinking things up. Okay, the movie Mulan has widely, at least within the queer community, been accepted as a queer-centric film. While it may not have been written that way on purpose, the movie has definitely helped many queer folks see themselves more clearly, whether that be through Mulan's drag, Shang being considered a bisexual character and subsequent icon,
as well as
the song Reflection being co-opted by trans people everywhere as a way to explain the trans experience. So my question for you is, how do you feel about the film being such an iconic and special film to queer people everywhere, and thus Mulan herself as a queer icon?
Wow! I love it! I love it! I love the question. I love the fact that I was able to be part of a character that had that as a residual, but also now poignant impact in the queer community. Because, you know, that definitely, I don't think, was in the form. Maybe it was, and I didn't have any idea, because I knew the story of Mulan growing up. And it's about her dressing up as a man to save her family and be a heroine. It's wonderful, because anytime there's a character that can help to... make someone feel like they're seen and that they're represented is just, I mean, it's an icing on top of a layer of icing. So I love the fact that that happened, and it's, you know, it's a testament to what a personal story like the story of Fa Mulan can have on a very universal level. You know, a very specific Chinese folklore became something that man, woman, trans, queer are all able to see a little of themselves in it. And it's all about, you know, Mulan trying to find who she is and what she's capable of and what her potential is, and only feeling like she was disappointing and failing. And in the end, because she just followed her own heart and believed what was right, that's the, you know, her reward was saving China, right? Her reward was becoming the heroine or the hero. It doesn't matter. It's just about finding your potential. So.
Thank you so much.
Thank you so
much.
Thank you. Well said. Thoughtful group here. Really thoughtful group here, you know?
It really is. That's amazing.
All right, go ahead over here.
Hello. Welcome to Canada. Really great to have you here, but...
Well, that didn't sound very enthusiastic. You're like, welcome to Canada. We're really thrilled to have you.
He's nervous.
I'm just joking.
I just wanted to ask a quick question. Just, you know, you've been part of so many big fan bases, and it's just been so great to see you play different strong roles in all these categories that we've seen in movies and TV shows. Has there been a fan base that you haven't touched on yet that you just love to be part of? And, you know, that could be like Harry Potter or Lord of the Rings or DC. Like, is there something that you've just always been like, oh, if I have the opportunity, I take it?
I don't want to be greedy. But be greedy, right? I can't say some of the projects that I'm working with, but I mean, I feel like, I mean, some people have mentioned Star Trek, and I've always been a Trekker, and I know Bill is here somewhere in the building.
He's coming up after you, actually.
Oh, well, there we go.
Stick around.
So maybe I should just hang out with him. But, you know, that would be a really incredible franchise to touch on. And what else can I touch?
That's good.
I don't know. I mean, I'm just grateful for anything that comes along. I hope I get to keep working. That's all. Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you so much.
Thank you for wanting to keep watching.
Okay, go ahead over here.
Hi.
Hi.
I'm a huge fan of Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D., and my question for you is, what was your most memorable behind-the-scenes moment with the Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D. cast?
The bookends. You know, the pilot episode that we shot together and getting, you know, to know each other and forming this group. And then our final scene. We actually filmed our final scene, you know, on one of the last days of the shoot, where we all said our sort of, not farewells, but, you know, see you later kind of thing. So, those are very special moments.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Hi. Go ahead.
Hello. I wanted to first mention that the Book of Boba is likely the first Star Wars media with indigenous representation as an indigenous story. And I was wondering, what kind of story would you want to see from, a minority within our world portrayed on Star Wars?
Yeah, I mean, Tim, I think, definitely had a massive influence, you know, in having John and Dave explore the Tuskens and explore that, you know, that storyline, because the Tuskens were always looked at as the savages, the bad guys, the animals of the planet. And in essence, those images were shattered quite a bit by those stories. I don't know. I think it would be interesting to see how they can incorporate a storyline, you know, because it takes place in a galaxy far, far away, right? So how do they bring on Asian elements? I mean, and they have touched on it in costumes and things like that, the influences of the Asian culture. don't know. That's a very good question. I'll have to think about that one. That's a heavy one. You guys are asking really heavy questions today. Can we talk about ice cream? What's your favorite flavor, May? Coffee. Thank you.
All right, go ahead over here.
Hi.
Sorry, can you just speak up a little louder?
The best parts of it were you and the cast, and I really missed them. So I was wondering if you've been in touch with them recently.
Oh, yeah. I was actually in London recently, and I got to see Ian, and I got to see Nick Blood and Jason O'Mara. And I keep in touch with so many of them. And I actually was recently at a wedding of my boss, Marissa Tenshman, and Jed Wheaton. Not their marriage, I'm sorry, they're already married, but Kevin, who actually directed an episode of The Book of Boba Fett. I feel like a big auntie with Kevin, so yeah, we do keep in touch a lot.
Thank you. Sure.
All right, people, I've got the dreaded 5-minute wrap warning, so we only have time for 2 more questions. I really apologize to the people that waited so patiently in line, but we'll have to cut it short after the next 2 questions, so we'll start on this side.
Hi.
Hi.
I'm a huge Marvel Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D. and a Star Wars fan. And while watching the Book of Boba Fett, I noticed that there's a lot of similarities between Melinda May and Fennec Shand.
Yeah.
So I was wondering if you took any characteristics from Melinda and used it while playing Fennec?
Yeah, I mean, you know, I only have one face, so when you're playing a badass character that doesn't emote very much, and they're both sort of like that, you know, I can only do so much of not showing too much emotions. I think the way I make a difference with the two of them is that, you know, Melinda May is very maternal. You know, she even though she doesn't show it because of her pain, she's very, very maternal, and she protects, and she... Fennec is not, you know. Fennec is all about, oh, this is good food, I'm gonna just eat it, and, you know, and, oh, you need to die because you're just in my way. So in a way for her, the way I play her character is she makes very, very selfish choices, and it's, we'll see where her character can evolve and go from there.
Thank you so much. Okay, final question for Ming-Na over here, please.
Hi.
Hello. Hi, Ming. Thank you so much for being here. It's really, really amazing.
Isn't it, though?
It is. It's
so amazing, right, that I'm here?
Yeah.
I'm joking, but thank you.
It's super surreal because, yeah, after COVID and everything, it's amazing. Now.
It really is. It's so great. Okay, what's your question? Hurry up.
Sorry. Your past self or to young people who are looking to get into the industry, especially as a woman and as a person who's not of like the visible majority?
Don't make it as an excuse that you don't succeed. That's it. Because you can be too short, too fat, too skinny, too blonde, too whatever. There'll always be a million excuses. So never let those thoughts get into your head. If it's something that you want to do, you do it. And you pursue it with all your heart and all your passion. And even if you knock down 100 times, you keep doing it because it's what you love. And one day, one door will open, and then another door will open, or another door opens into a new arena that you had no idea that you'll also love. So just, you have to not make excuses. Because if I did that, I would have been, you know, a doctor or running my parents' restaurant at this time, which also is nothing wrong with that either. But I just believed it with my whole heart. So that would be my advice.
Have you considered motivational speaking? Well, thank you so much for your candor and your wonderful stories and your lessons of empowerment, you know? Yeah, we really appreciate it.
Liz, listen, seriously, I was that little girl sitting alone in my room, playing with my Star Wars toys, drawing pictures of myself as Han Solo, the female version.
Now there's a toy of you.
And now there's a toy of me. So.
Give it